and it's also being revealed to us. So we laugh as well as the Most High. Because he laughs, we laugh too, because we know your plans, the Illuminati,
right.
NATO, Russia. You're trying to lock horns and try to set off a last world war, thinking you're still going to rule after that. But Yahweh Ba'asham Yahweh Shai is going to flip it on you. He's going to give it to his servants, the men of the Lord, right?
Yeah,
that's
Yeah, that's a beautiful point, Ash. That's beautiful, you know, and that just proves that, you know, that the Most High is revealing things on both sides. So now that we know this truth, you know, as men, we have to come out here on the highways and the byways, just like Ezekiel prophesying to the wind. All right, and we got to teach our people this word, because this is our only defense against what this so-called white man got, you know, for our people. Because we know, yo, we not fools up here. All right, we do research. The Rex 84, the martial law, all right, the concentration camps. We know about all your plans, Esau. It's already been, you already been made bare through the spirit of Yahweh Ba'asham Yahweh Shai. It's being revealed onto our apostles, and our apostles are feeding us. And then we doing the research, and we know exactly what you're going to do. You know what I'm saying? So just how the Lord knows what they're going to do, the scriptures say declaring the end from the beginning. Because even Moses knew about the end days. Mm. See what I'm saying? Even Moses knew.
Enoch
knew. Enoch prophesied. See what I'm saying? So this is an ancient knowledge that's being passed down, and the Most High was never going to do away with this.
That's right.
The Bible is still here 3,000, 4,000 years later, and the prophecies are still relevant. It's still a living water. It's still a spring of life. See what I'm saying? So read that in Zechariah 8 and 16 real quick. All right?
Zechariah chapter 8, verse 16. These are the things that ye shall do.
Right. These are the things that ye shall do. So now that we know the truth, now that we know that we the Israelites, see what I'm saying? We the bones have been, the Most High put the skin, the sinews, and the flesh. He put the breath in us. You see what I'm saying? Now these are the things he shall do. Continue on.
Speak ye every man the truth to his neighbor.
Right. Speak ye every man the truth to his neighbor. So this is the truth, the Bible.
Cut.
So we speaking to our neighbor. It doesn't mean knock on your neighbor's door. You live in 3F, go to 3G. You know what I'm saying? Yo, the truth. No. Speak ye unto your neighbor is the children of Israel, right? The nation of Israel. Speak ye the truth. Read it one more time, and then keep reading.
All right. Zechariah chapter 8, verse 16. These are the things that ye shall do. Speak ye every man the truth to his neighbor.
Right.
Execute the judgment of truth and peace in your gates.
Right. Execute the judgment. Say it one more time. Select.
All right. Execute the judgment of truth and peace in your gates.
Right, execute the judgment and truth in your gates. So these are the gates right here, because basically the gate is where you enter in through a city.
Right.
So nowadays, you know, everything is different. Esau fucking jacked everything up, all right? We read that earlier, the foundation of the earth are out of course. There's supposed to be gates and stuff, you know, guarding the city, walls and stuff, protecting us from the enemies. You know what I'm saying? But this shit is mad base out here. The train station, you could say though, today a train station will be like a modern day gate. But even going on a deeper level, all right, in the spirit, the gate is really the people, all right, the men, which are the leaders and the protectors of the nation. So we coming out here, we really speaking this to the men. We know that, yeah, this is the gate right here.
There's gates all over the city.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Especially the shopping areas, because they have to gate up the goods. They have to gate up the food. They have to gate up the banks. There's gates all over this city. So we know this is the gated city, which is Babylon the Great.
That's right.
Because this is where the riches is on. This is where the Israelites are prophesying.
Yeah, Amos 5 and 15. Yeah, so that's what we was commanded to do, to come out here to the gates to execute judgment and truth. You know what I'm saying? We're not going to start knocking people out and shit. We're not executing that type of judgment. The judgment that we executing is words. But pretty soon, Yahweh Ba'asham Yahweh Shai is going to bring a physical judgment on this place, on the land of America. And it's going to be, the Lord said that, you can get that real quick, but by fire and by his sword shall the Lord plead with all flesh. You know, we know that the Lord is not going to plead with you how we pleading with you. Because right now, you might be intimidated because we speaking loud, or we might be using the so-called F-bombs. You see what I'm saying? That intimidates you. Oh, who are these men? But when the Lord come back, he's not going to say shit. The Lord is not saying nothing. He's just straight up whacking and you know what I'm saying, and killing people. That's what the Lord is going to do when he comes back. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, so read that real quick.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 66, verse 15. For behold, the Lord will come with fire and with his chariots like a whirlwind. to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire.
Right, so that's the Lord's rebuke. You see what I'm saying? That our rebuke, which is really the Lord's rebuke too, but we can't execute that judgment right now because we just on a lower level. Right now, we are the angels that, like it says in the book of Jude, that fell from their first estate. So we know we can't really truly execute the true judgments that we want to do, which is the Lord's judgments. But right now, we just commanded to come out here and teach, like we read in Zechariah, teach every man's neighbor. All right, but that's the rebuke that the Lord is coming with. The chariots, like I said earlier, the chariots of a whirlwind is really the so-called UFOs that the white man called UFOs, which they're not really unidentified because we know what they are. And even the higher illuminated ones, the Illuminati, they know that the chariots are the UFOs are the chariots of the Lord. So it just said that's how he's coming back. Basically, the Lord's second coming, like the brother said earlier, is basically that movie War of the Worlds. Just so you could have a vision in your mind. You know, because when you read these scriptures, you're supposed to envision this like it's real, because it is real. This is really going to happen. So you got to have a picture in your mind of sort of how it's going to play out. The Lord is coming back with thousands upon thousands of chariots. Thousands of UFOs is going to flood these skies. And according to what we just read, the rebuke is going to be with fire and fury. So that means what? Death. The Lord is bringing back death. He said, I come not to bring peace on the earth, but a sword. You know, I have come not to send peace, but I'm come to send a sword. Mm-hmm. And I think there was more on that verse. If you could read the next verse.
Verse 16. For by fire and by his sword will Yahweh plead with all flesh.
Right.
And the slain of Yahweh, by Hashem Yahweh Shai, shall be many.
Right, that many is the same. Yo, that's crazy, because Yahweh Shai gave an example of the straight gate. And the wide gate, you know what I'm saying? The wide gate it said many there be that find it that shall be destroyed, you know, roughly paraphrasing it. So that many that Yahweh Bashim Yahshai is gonna put to death is the many people that's following after the ways of this world. You know what I'm saying? Not following the straight gate. This is a straight gate right here. There's only four of us right now. You see what I'm saying? Compared to all these people walking down the street, all these people is gonna die if they don't repent. You see what I'm saying? So that's the Lord is not playing. Right now, the Lord is giving you a chance to repent and to come back to the law, statutes, and commandments if you are of the nation of Israel. You know, because repentance, the Lord only came for Israel. Yahweh Shai, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ, only came for the nation of Israel.
That's right.
All right, and when he comes back his second time, he's only coming back for the elect of the nation of Israel.
God.
So all you other nations, you automatically are eliminated out of that salvation.
Right.
But even 2/3 of the Lord's own people is included in that many that's going to be destroyed.
All
right, so read that in Amos real quick.
We started on 15 or 14?
What did it say on 14? Yeah, you could start at that.
This is Amos chapter 5, verse 14. Seek good and not evil, that ye may live. And so the Lord, the power of hosts, Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, shall be with you. As he's spoken, hate the evil and love the good, and establish judgment in the gate. Right.
Hate the evil and love the good, because everybody want to say God is love, but he's commanding Amos to hate evil. So we know these are just lies. The Christian church is lying to our people by saying God is all love. Because when you read the Bible for yourself, it gives you specific instruction on how you're supposed to conduct yourself. As a follower, you call yourself a Christian, which means a follower of what? Of Christ. See what I'm saying? But there's an instruction of what you gotta be like if you call yourself a follower of Christ. If you call yourself a Christian, there's a certain way you gotta carry yourself, and you're supposed to hate evil. So we hate adultery. Yes, we hate the fact that our brothers are sleeping with our other brothers' wives. All right, yo, you can get that on the camera real quick. This is judgment. I don't even know what's going on up there, but if they need, you know, this so-called white man to come in and save them for some shit, there's some shit going on up there.
Yep.
See what I'm saying? There's something going on.
Yeah, there's always judgment in this city.
Right, there's always judgment. You know what I'm saying? So, and it's because, again, you know, the righteousness is not being executed in America. It's because this place is being ruled by the elites, by the wicked, the so-called white men. So these dead bones, our people gotta wake up, because this thing is about to go down soon. This so-called white man is not gonna be just walking down the street with his kids, you know, smiling at you with his teeth. There's gonna be a time where he's gonna be trying to kill you for the little bit of food that you got. Just like the Book of Eli, all these movies, they call them dystopian films.
That's right.
You know, which is films that depict last day scenarios or end time situations and stuff like that.
They also call it apocalyptic films.
Right, apocalyptic film. That's another one.
Things at the end of days when there's a lack of food, lack of water, is lawlessness, you know what I'm saying? Society has broken down. The police forces are, you know, scattered. The police forces are going to, they're going to be fighting for their own lives. You think the police, when this society breaks down and the U.S. dollar is worthless, the police forces are not going to, because there's nothing to work for. You know, they're not going to work for the Constitution or all that bullshit. They're going to retreat back into their own houses, their own lives. And it's going to be straight up chaos out here, you know what I'm saying?
Right,
this is what we're trying to do our part right here for the Most High to protect us in these last days. Because we pray and hasten the day that this society collapses.
That's
one day you're going to wake up, the U.S. dollar is not going to be worth anything in this society. Then you're going to see that this was always a paper-thin society.
Yep.
The Constitution is what holds this society together. That's craziness. It's the Bible that's supposed to hold society together.
Right. Yet they're a God-fearing nation.
Exactly. And they put that on their dollar bill, you know, and that shit is wickedness, man. They put "in God we trust." You know what I'm saying? That, yo, just read that real quick. Read that in Ezekiel again, verse 10.
Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 10. "So I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath came into them."
Right, so hold on, one point real quick. It says, "So I prophesied as he commanded me." We just read two scriptures, Zechariah 8 and 16, and Amos 5 and 15, of what we're supposed to do. You see what I'm saying? How are we supposed, what are we being commanded to do? To come out into the gates of the city and execute righteous judgment. So when people say only God can judge me, that's a lie. Because the Ezekiel judge, Amos judge, Zechariah judge, all the prophets was judging the people. You see what I'm saying? They wasn't grabbing rocks and stoning people and stuff like that. Because the mercy, you know, the law of mercy is in effect right now. But like the brother was saying, once this society collapsed, that's going to be the green light from Yahweh Bashim Yahshua to his army that this thing is over. That's it. The mercy is over.
Right.
Now it's going to be hunters. You could get that real quick in Jeremiah 16 and read that again. I'll continue on where you was at. See what I'm saying? That mercy is going to be cut off. That's when this is going to happen.
Ezekiel 37, verse 10. Chapter 37, verse 10. "So I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived, and stood upon their feet, an exceeding great army."
So there you go. That exceeding great army. What's the purpose of an army? To kill shit. To defend and to attack. So the Lord is building up an exceeding great army in these last days of the house of Israel, because nobody's included in this. We just read that in verse 11. These bones of the house of Israel, these same bones are the same bones that are being built up to be an exceeding great army.
God.
You see what I'm saying? Read that real quick.
The book of Jeremiah 16, verse 16. "Behold, I will send for many fishers, saith Yahweh, and they shall fish them."
God, so the fishers right now is what we doing. We fishing. We putting the word out. We casting a word. And people get caught on it. You know, they want to hear, "Oh, what is this about?" It could be a good fish, a bad fish. You know, that's really the Lord's doing. The Lord really got to wake your mind up to understand the truth. We just fishing. You know what I'm saying? We just throwing the line out. That's all we doing. That's all Ezekiel had to do. Ezekiel was told, "Say, thus saith the Lord this, thus saith the Lord that, do this, say this." That's all we doing. We just taking the commandments from Yahweh Bashim Yahshua, just like a good soldier does take the commandment and do it. But what's gonna happen after when the brother was talking about the chaos breaking out, martial law, the FEMA camps, the concentration camp, what's gonna happen after that? I'll read that right there.
"And after will I send for many hunters."
For many hunters. What does a hunter do? It hunts, it kills. You know what I'm saying? That's the point of an army. So the Lord is sending us out as fishers, but pretty soon those fishers are gonna become hunters. You know, through the spirit of Yahweh Bashim Yahshua.
Yeah, the hunters lock into a prey. And that prey is Esau.
Right.
Esau is a so-called white man, but we know the chariots and Yahweh Shai is gonna deal with the army, the military. And the Most High is going to have some of his people rise up and put these Edomites to death on these streets. Also, the two-thirds is going to run into the men of the Lord as well.
That's right.
According to the book of Ezekiel. Those hunters are going to, mark them, those people. To the others, he said in my hearing, smite. Mm-hmm. He's going to smite old men, old women, young children, young babies. Why? Because that's the will of the Lord. It's not me that's saying it. Thus saith Yahweh in the prophecies, all
right? That's right.
So a lot of our people is going to fall to those hunters, which is the men of the Lord.
That's right.
Israelites.
Khan. So if you could get me a quick precept on Jeremiah 51 and 20, and just hold that and keep reading on that.
Well, so I get your precept to
them. Oh, yeah. Right. The water.
All right, this Revelation chapter 11, verse 11. And after 3 days and a half, the spirit of life from Yahweh Bashim Yahushai entered into them.
Right, so this is the same thing that we're reading about in Ezekiel. The breath that was given onto those dry bones for them to live. It's the same thing. This is talking about the last days. Because this is the only captivity that we've ever been in that we don't know who we are.
That's right.
You see what I'm saying? So that dry bone, that prophecy, which we're going to get more on it, Lord willing, we're going to read the rest of the chapter. They didn't even know who they were, those dry bones. You see what I'm saying? So this has to be a prophecy of the last day. We see in the exceeding great army, the brother brought out the precept in Revelation 14, the lamb stood on the mountain with the 144,000. What do you think they was going to do? They was hunting. They was ready to hunt. To hunt the Edomites, to the Psalms 148, the other nations, the Psalm 148, even the two-thirds, right? Psalms 148 tells you that the kings and the nobles are going to be bound into chains and fetters of iron. That's the hunting process. You see what I'm saying? That's the elect, the 144,000 men with Yahushua and the angels. So this same thing, the prophecy that we're reading right there, start from the top one more time.
All right. And after 3 days and a half, the spirit of life from the Most High entered into them, and they stood upon their feet, and great fear fell upon them which saw them.
Right, great fear fell upon them that saw them. That links up with Wisdom of Solomon, the fifth chapter. When it says they stood in great boldness in the face of their enemies, that's the same bones that was brought back to life. And now we standing out here prophesying the words of Yahweh Bashim Yahushai to our people, you know. And this army, you know, that it's speaking about, it's making people afraid, you know. Especially these Amalek. You see him just walking by. These people are afraid, you know, but they mostly that's speaking about starting with the elites. That's why they got all these programs, like they got some new thing on Google. I can't remember the name. Maybe I could just find it real quick. It's a new program that they got that they have a coding program that filters through certain words. So you know they got the word Israelite in there. You already know. Yep. Israelite, Yahweh, Yahushai, all the buzzwords, so you know, just for lack of a better term, that we use as Israelites. You see what I'm saying? But they're afraid of this truth. They're afraid that these prophecies are really gonna come to pass. Because the whole time they thought they was living in their pride. It tells you that in the book of Obadiah, the pride of that heart has deceived thee. They thought they was really gonna get away with all this. They thought they was gonna just live forever. Like they was just gonna have a kingdom forever. But the Lord got his prophets back on the earth again, starting with the apostles of Great Millstone. You see, so that exceeding great army is scaring the shit out of these people. So what did I tell you to get again?
Jeremiah 51 and 20.
Yeah, there you go, yeah.
Jeremiah 51, verse 20. Thou art my battle axe and weapons of war. For with thee will I break in pieces the nation.
Right, with thee I will break in pieces the nation. The Lord said, and that's again talking to the Israelites, because this book, Psalms 147, it was only given to Jacob. So Jacob, which is the Israelites, could you get the sign real quick? Which is the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. This is the Lord's battle axe. This is the Lord's weapon of war. He's not gonna come down here and actually hit you with a sword. He's gonna have his men that we're reading about, the great army that these people are afraid of, which is the 144,000, the elect. He's gonna break the nations with those men. He's gonna put it into the spirit of the men of the Lord to start killing you people out
here.
That's
right.
And it's coming very soon. It's coming very soon, because all of these prophecies, all these calamities that's coming in South America, you see like the landslides, the famines, the riots and stuff like that, the protests, not race riots, but that's coming soon too. But you know, they mostly protesting against government. It tells you that in the book of Ezra, when you shall see great earthquakes and uproars of the people, it is the very same time which the highest shall begin to visit the earth, which he made. So this time is coming. What we're reading right now is right around the corner. You got people that's trying to put far off the evil day. You know what I'm saying? This is coming soon. These battle axes, yo, that, Lord willing, man, that's us. And if we already know that the Lord is gonna raise up men and we out here doing this, how much time you think you got? How much time you think you got? Just like the movie I Am Legend, when the dogs was, the sunlight had to disappear. Remember, it was that little crack of sunlight? And when once that sunlight was gone, like the scriptures say, let us work therefore in the day. Because when the night cometh, when no man can work, once that sunlight goes down, it's over for you. That's it. It's
That's
over.
Right.
It's gonna be no mercy, because the Lord is gonna put His spirit that we're reading about in Ezekiel 37 into His men to perform His will.
God.
So keep reading that.
And with thee will I destroy kingdoms.
That's a cut.
Yeah, that's heavy, man. Yo, read that one more time, Mark.
Jeremiah 51, verse 20. Thou art my battle axe and weapons of war. For with thee will I break in pieces the nations.
Hold on, wait. I thought God is love.
Unity, right?
Hold on. God is love and unity, but why He got a people that He set them up as a weapons of war?
To break.
To destroy. Keep reading, Mark.
To break in pieces the nations, and with thee will I destroy kingdoms.
Damn, so that's beautiful right there, man. And that's what we hoping for. That's what we hastening for the day of the Lord. Because we know that according to Obadiah, Esau was going to be ruling on the last days. And you could get that in 2 Ezra. You could get that real quick. Because it just said he would destroy kingdoms, right? With thee I will destroy kingdoms. So let's go to 2 Ezra 6 and 9. And let's see. When the Lord comes back, who's going to be ruling, and what kingdom is the Lord going to use His men to destroy? Are we going to destroy? Was this going to happen 200 years from now, or is this going to happen in the next kingdom when so-called Chinese people, the Moabites, they say, "Oh, we got next." Is that when this is going to be fulfilled? Read that real quick, guys.
2 Ezra chapter 6, verse 9. For Esau is the end of the world. And Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth.
Right, Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth, the Israelites. So this is the world to come. So if the Lord is going to use these people to break in pieces the kingdoms and destroy nations, what do you think is going to happen after that? They're going to build their own kingdom.
That's right.
Which is the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. So this is what's coming to the planet Earth. This is what we out here to prophesy to our people. But it's like they don't want that. They don't want a kingdom of their own. They'd rather just stay here forever. They'd rather stay here forever and raise their children in an environment that you got men that's dressing up like women, having your children all confused, looking at them like, "Oh, what's that?" Thinking that's okay. You see what I'm saying? Then if you say something against it, you could get fined money. You could actually pay a fine if you homophobic or you are. They got so many damn terms for that shit. It's crazy. So many defenses against these homosexuals. You can't even really say homosexual. That's a hate. Yo, you hate. You see what I'm saying? But the Lord just said He's gonna use people to destroy nations. So that God is love, that's destroyed. That God is not just love. God is love for the Israelites. That's it. God is not love for the other nations. Go ahead, Art.
Slaka, you were saying that Israel don't want their own kingdom. Well, because this is the vibration that's on our people right now. The black Americans and all these tribes right here. This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 2, verse 14. Is Israel a servant? Is he a homeborn slave? Why is he spoiled? So our people, you know, they have that vibration because they want to be servants.
Right.
They want to be slaves and they're homeborn in this country. There's many of our people, so-called African-American, they say, "Yo, I'm a true American. I'm a true American." But this is the land of our captivity. Even though some of us were here for thousands of years, the Native Americans, still, this land was conquered by our oppressors. So we have to come back out of that and return to the heavenly kingdom that's promised to us and promised to our forefathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. We're not supposed to be homeborn slaves. We're not supposed to be